here is our power pack with hydraulics for truck mounted installations. It is a self-contained unit with the controls, the curbside mounted controls, all mounted down low. We have the control panel, which controls the vacuum pump, which controls the pressure washer pump, which controls the tipping and dumping features of the spoils. It also contains a vacuum pressure gauge, which would monitor the condition of your filter, a tachometer, an hour meter, as well as voltmeter. Those are all mounted down low, as well as the hydraulic reservoir with heat exchanger. It's got a A, B, and selector switch on it, which will allow for front-mounted auxiliary hydraulic hoses to be used for a jackhammer or a saw or a submersible pump, or you throw the selector valve the other way and it turns your valve turning equipment. On the top of the power pack is the power source. It's available using either gas or hydraulics. This is a 27 horsepower twin. It's also available in a 26.5 horse diesel. You have your 12-volt battery, as well as antifreeze tank. Right below the antifreeze tank is your selector valve. You pull fluid from the antifreeze tank, or by selecting the valve, you'll pull fluid from your fresh water tank. Next to it also is your pressure control valve. Touching on the back features of this power pack, you see here the pressure washer pump, the hydraulic pump, and the vacuum pump. These are both independently switchable from the front control panel through those electromechanical clutches. On the side, we have tagged a hose which would run to your fresh water tank, another hose that would run to the pressure washer hose reel. Located on the lower deck is an electric over hydraulic power pack that controls the tipping and opening functions of your spoils tank. Tagged down low are the hoses that would tie to the bulkhead on the front side of that spoils tank. Your fuel tank. We also have 25 feet of hydraulic hose, a half inch pressure and a 3/4 return that runs to your onboard valve turning equipment. And then around the far side, off the control panel, are all your watertight connections for the tank. We have for the lighting systems, for your valve turner, water level, strobe lights and service lights. Anything that would be interfaced off the front control panel, the connection point for it is located on the side, and the external wire harness ties all those features in. Located under the vacuum pump is a 3-inch elbow. Here we would tie in the filter off the spoils tank to this elbow. It's a 250-gallon spoils tank. Some of the important features about this particular unit: it has our sliding dumping feature, which this particular ram down here will articulate the tank back 12 inches when it reaches the end of its stroke. It then tips the tank up 45 degrees. It also has hydraulic latch doors, so once it is flipped up 45 degrees from a remote position, the operator can engage these rams, and the latch will open up and the door will then swing open. It's got a mechanical high-level shut-off ball system located under this access hatch. On the far side of the tank is the filtration system. It is a two-stage filtration system with easy access on the back side of the unit. On the back of the tank, we have hose storage for your 30-foot hose attached to the to your wand. That would then store wrapped around these arms. Depending on the installation, it's on the back of a truck. This is a vacuum brake. When your hose gets plugged up and you need to be able to free the obstruction, you can either operate it from down low, if it's mounted up on a truck, reach up there, this opens up the vacuum brake, It allows you to disconnect your hose, reverse it, try and get the obstruction back in there, close it from here, and then you have your ball drain right here. Before you, if you get yourself in this situation, you're loaded with mostly fluids, you can go ahead and break the ball valve open and pour out a lot of the fluids that's contained inside the spoils tank. This particular unit is one part of a multi-part system used on the back of the truck. What you see mounted alongside here on the pallet are the two pressure ones used with the hydro excavation portion, which is pressurized water. The short one used for cleaning the inside of your tank and the rest of the equipment, and a long one used for actually doing the potholing. On this particular side of the unit, what you're going to have is a 3-inch hose coming off your filter. It's secured to your tank, and we have approximately 20 feet of extra hose. This will loop around and run to your power pack. And on the front side of the skid of the tank are your hydraulic bulkhead connections. We have four of them. We have a pressure and tank for your slide and tip feature, and pressure and tank for your door latches. This is our 125-gallon horizontal fresh water tank. It's got an 8-inch fill on top, and it comes with mounting hardware for truck body installation.